Hello, everybody. Welcome back to another episode of ZetaCraft. My name is Zane, and we are starting off in our industrial district again because we have some work to do on this very, very boring portal here. Now, if we're going to have other members of ZetaCraft coming here to buy items from, say, our bone meal farm or our flower farm way over there or our tree farm, we're going to need to make this place in general, but mainly the portal, a little more beautiful. And in order to make this more beautiful, I have gathered some materials just in this one shulker box, and we're going to hop into a quick little time lapse. So, let's go! Now that I have this nice portal design here, you don't really want to come out of here and see that or nothing really anywhere. That's kind of boring and does not look very good. So what I'm thinking is I build up some pathways to each of these buildings, make a better storage place that isn't in the middle of nowhere, out in the open. Have it be maybe over here in a nice small little building. Nothing too fancy, because most storage is going to be in the actual farms. But have pathways leading all the way over here. And like I said, to each of these buildings. And then I can branch off pathways to each of the new farms I add here. So why don't I go collect some resources and we'll just go right into the time lapse. Let's go! Well, and just like that, we are all done with this first kind of part of the beautification of the industrial district. We have this beautiful portal here, and as you can tell, I kind of went all out on the pathways and greenery around the area. So first off, I'll just start here because it's what I first built, is the new storage room for all my items. So we got all the honey stuff, building blocks, dirt, wood, slabs, random stuff, wool, lighting. So it just works out really well. I really like it. It doesn't need to be too big, as most items here will be just in the actual farms themselves. And after I built that in the time lapse, I started to dig out the roads and make the pathways. And I really, really like the gradient or block palette that I used, as I think all of the blocks go well with each other. Then once I finished all of that, I decided to add in the hills, the dirt hills, just to make it more singular, so it's not like the pathways are here and then you're staring out into the open. That is the rest of this plot. There's literally nothing back there, so I wanted to make these hills to reduce the sightline and make the player or the person focus on the pathway rather than seeing emptiness behind. And the dirt hills over here did a pretty good job. But without them, you kind of still see into nothingness. So I decided to add in the grass, which helped a little bit. But then I really put in the azalea trees, the flowering azalea trees, and that really, really helped, as that even further reduced the sightline. And then I decided to add some bamboo with some string on top, and that really, really focused in the area that I want the person to, like, really pay attention to, is the pathway and not get emptiness out into an open field. And I added in the fence to kind of as a visual guide to guide the person along the path rather than just here's the path, walk along however you want. The fences guide the person and it kind of focuses them onto the path rather than them just walking like this. That doesn't make any sense with the fences here. You want to walk around the fences. It's just a natural thing that, you know, you just kind of naturally do even in real life. You walk around fence, you don't walk up like behind the fence, you walk along the fences. So it kind of just guides the player. However, with the beautification of this industrial district, there is a purpose behind this other than, you know, just making it look good, is to have Zetacraft members come here to buy items, buy shulker boxes of wood or shulker boxes of bone meal or blue flowers and other farms as we build them up. But that requires a shop for them to go to see what the prices are rather than having to come all the way out here to figure that out. And as the last episode showed, we got our order in with Time Architect, so we actually need to go meet up with him somewhere. I'm not exactly sure where, but we're about to go meet up with him just so that we can discuss the building of this as he has design all set up. So let's actually head over at least to Starter Town or to the shopping district to meet up with Time. Knock, knock, Time. Hello? Anyone here?
Is that a Zame?
Where's the door? Where's the door?
Wait. That's one of these. Just any of them.
Oh, I can't get in.
Oh.
Oh, wait.
Well.
No, that's not going to work. That's fine. I'm in.
Welcome.
I'm in. I hacked the mainframe. I'm in.
Oh, he's in.
Hello, Time. So you messaged me saying that you got my order and that you might have something for me?
Yeah, so I just wanted to talk to you and just make sure that we're on the same page as far as the design concepts, locations, and then, of course, we got to discuss prices.
Yeah, well, I don't want to give too much of the design away to the viewers, but the designs looked fantastic, as always, from Time Architect. Would expect nothing less than perfection.
At Architect and Designs, we have world-class designers, builders, fabricators, contractors, you name it, we got it.
Well, I don't think you showed me where the plot was that you wanted to put this in the shopping district. So maybe we can go take a look at that spot, see if liking.
Of course. I've mapped out a very... Ah, thank you. Mapped out quite a few pristine locations. And we're going to start with my personal one. Places like this can go quick, so we need to make sure that if this place suits you, that we can jump on it quick.
Right, right.
And it would be this nice empty parcel right here below us.
Ooh. Gotta get an aerial view, gotta get the drone view.
Yeah, take a look around, just right close to the portal and just close to downtown, all the amenities. I think that it'll get really good traffic being right over in this location.
Yeah, I think this is a great, great plot of land you picked out. Prime real estate. So,
all right, so we'll go ahead and secure this place.
Yes, yes. I quite like this plot here. I think it'll go well. So what's, this plot is prime real estate, quite expensive, and your designs are obviously impeccable. What does, something like this go for?
So our standard rate is one diamond block per chunk squared. So I'd have to pull up my F3 screen here. We're looking at upwards of 2.5, maybe 3 chunks.
Oh boy.
And
all right.
The design,
all right.
I'm thinking go vertical. So
Right.
That adds up quick and being a very sought after parcel. I'm thinking it might come around somewhere in the 20 blocks before materials.
Oh boy. Ooh, 20 blocks. All right. How about a discount for a bro?
Oh.
No, what can I? Ooh. Someone's looking fashionable here. So what kind
bros?
Of Yeah, what kind of discount does a bro get?
I'll do it for free.
For free? All right, you got me at free.
For a bro.
For a bro. High five. Perfect.
All right. Perfect. I'll get right on it and give you updates as we're getting ready to build.
Sweet. If you know, since you're doing it for free, if you need help building, I'm more than happy to jump in and help with this build.
Of course. Of course.
Now, getting blocks, that's all on you, but I'll help build it. I'll help build it.
All right. Well, luckily we have plenty of contractors and all of that that specialize in that type of responsibilities.
Perfect. Well, I can't wait to see how this thing turns out, and I'm sure the viewers are going to love this thing.
It's going to be out of this world.
Literally. Well, I will let you get to it then. I know you're busy, but I'm paying for free for this thing, so you might as well get right on it. After meeting with time, I think we will end the episode here. I did add a little water feature to the place to add a little more detail. I might add some different blocks in here to make it look a little more textured, but just a simple little water thing. But like I said, I think that will end today's episode. So I hope everyone stays happy, stays healthy, and I shall see you all next time. Goodbye.